Okay, guys, forgot to cut the video on when I first started. Sorry about that. I've got my compound slide set to 12 degrees. And this customer wanted the taper up to 3/4 of an inch. So I've got a scribed line at 3/4 of an inch. And all I'm doing now is taking about a 1/10th pass off each time, and at 12 degrees on a 3/4 diameter, when I get to 1/4 inch at the end of it, which is what the customer wanted, at that angle it'll come out to where that taper ends up at the 3/4 inch mark. But anyway, here goes a bunch of boring lathe work. Run it back, and I take the cross light in 1/10 each time is where I get the depth of my cut. The compound slide just runs back and forth at the same angle each time. Over 10,000. Ten thousandths per side, which is 20,000 overall. How well that scribed line shows up in the video. Let me try to mark that real quick so you can see each time that we're getting a little bit closer and closer. Good old Sharpies. The 10,000 on the cross slide. Bring the cutter in slow until you get started with the cut. Now the whole process is pretty slow, but when you enter the cut, you want to be careful and enter it real slow. You may see some smoke coming off of the what looks like smoke coming off of the workpiece at times. If you do, that's the oil getting hot and smoking. It's not the metal or the cutter, it's the oil. It's the heat creates a little smoke from the oil. If I had a bigger lathe, this wouldn't take near as long. I could take deeper cuts and run it at a higher speed, but keep from stripping anything out on this little 7 to 10 Harbor Freight, you have to go pretty easy on it. But one of these days, good Lord willing, I'll have a bigger, better lathe, metal lathe. I've got a nice wood lathe. What I wouldn't give for a nice metal lathe. These Harbor Freight 7 by 10s are fine for small work and for cutting relatively soft materials, brass, aluminum, mild steel. But start cutting any hardened steel, they just really not beefy enough. The gear train on them is really not beefy enough to handle it. Of course, if you notice, with each pass that I make, we're getting a little bit closer to my scribed line up there. As I said, when I get finished, or when I make it to that scribed line, the tip of it will be right at a quarter inch diameter, which is what the customer wanted for this spoon bit. Since I had a parting tool shatter last night, had a piece of metal fly into my eye, my only good eye, legally blind in one eye, and it never fails. If something like that happens, it always gets in the good eye. But all my safety glasses are scratched all to shit, so I didn't have them on last night, and I got a sore eye today, thanks to my stupidity. But yes, I have an old pair of scratched up safety glasses on. Running any kind of equipment, especially metalworking equipment, always take your time, stay safe, wear your safety equipment, because one little accident can change everything or even end everything if you're not real careful. just taking this video with my cell phone camera, so hopefully it'll show up fairly well. Hand and arm gets tired cranking this knob after so long. Once I get the angle cut, I'll use a file to radius the tip of it. Not supposed to ever use a file on while you're running a lathe. If you do, do not use a standard file with a pointed end on it. Normal handle. If you're going to use a file on a lathe, which I don't recommend, but if you're going to, take you a file, round the back of it, a nice smooth edge. Because if that thing was to catch and you were using one with a point, it would shove it straight through your hand. And I'll show you how I hold mine when I get to that part. But I don't hold my file with the end of it in my hand. I hold it with my fingers to where if it was to catch, that it will kick it through my hand and not under my hand and not through my hand. But again, I don't recommend using a file on a lathe. I've been running metalworking equipment for years, so I've got quite a bit of experience, but using a file on a lathe is not something that I would recommend, especially if you don't have much experience running a lathe. You can get hurt bad real quick. stop the video for just a second and turn this fan off over here. It's probably affecting the audio.
Okay.
Got that fan turned off. Hopefully the air conditioner's not making too much noise for the video. And while I had the lathe stopped, I added just a little bit more angle, about another half a degree. And okay, if you when I first started cutting, I was taking 10/1000ths of an inch passes and going real slow, removing a lot of metal. But when I start getting closer, I want a smoother cut, so I speed the lathe speed up, increase the lathe speed, and start taking lighter cuts, 5/1000ths or less. But we'll get started back here. Notice the lathe spinning faster now. Going relatively fast with the compound slide because I'm not quite where I want to be yet. Taking a lighter cut like this, I can run the compound across a little bit faster than I was doing before. Almost to my scribed line. If I get a little bit closer, I'll take a lighter cut, or an even lighter cut than I've been taking here. Just so that it'll leave a smoother finish. Videotaping it, I'm probably going faster than I would if I wasn't taping. Which is not necessarily a good thing. I tend to get a little excited if I'm videotaping or in a hurry, but like I said, always need to be careful, take your time.
completely.
Looks like I'm just now getting into the front side of my striped lane. Taking about a 2 or 3 thousandths of an inch pass on each one of these. Okay, I'm into my scribe line now. Take a couple of real light passes. The tip of the bit down here is right at a quarter of an inch diameter, and the length of the taper from the tip to this point right here where the angle goes to the straight cylindrical is 3/4 of an inch, which is by the customer's specifications. And now I'm going to speed the lathe up a little bit more, and probably won't be any talking because it'll be hard to hear my voice over the lathe. Probably already has been. But I'll probably only take a 0.5 thousandth or a 1/1000th of an inch cut on each one of these just to smooth the finish out a little bit more. another thing, don't ever use a rag to wipe anything on the lathe. If you're going to use anything, use a paper towel, something that will tear and it'll rip it away from your hand. And not, if you use a towel and it gets caught in your hand, it can rip a hand off in a heartbeat. Okay, so that's looking pretty smooth right there. I'll switch to the file now. Never reach over a lathe while it's running. Okay, as I said before, if you're going to use a file on a lathe, use one that has the back of it rounded. You can't buy them like that, or not that I've seen. So just put it on a grinder and grind that point off the back side of it. And this is how I shape the radius on the tip of it. Don't use a whole lot of pressure. You notice the file is pointing away from the palm of my hand, so that if it was to catch, it'll shoot it under my hand and not through my hand. Hopefully you can see in the video that's starting to take a radius to it. And I'll hit it just a little bit up here too to blend this transition area. And then once I get done with the file, then I'll go over it with probably some 220 or 360 grit sandpaper to finish smoothing it out. Okay guys, I stopped the video for just a minute. This file that I was using is about wore out and getting pretty dull, so I thought it'd be a good opportunity to show you again what I was talking about on the files. This is the same file that I showed a few minutes ago that had the sharp point, like for putting a wood handle over the end of it. And I just took it over to the bench grinder and well, first of all, I cut the point off with the die grinder and took it over to the bench grinder and just rounded the end of that over so it'd have a nice radius, smooth radius on the end of it, and then over to the wire wheel to make sure there was no burrs or anything left on it. And I'll do a little bit more shaping here. And again, the file, and it's better to have a long one so that you can let it come past the palm of your hand. Hopefully you can see that. The other one was about to get too short. tapping the file out on the bench there to knock some of the metal dust out of it. Again, I don't know how well all of this is showing up on the video, but stop for just a second and check my radius here. Customer wanted it to be about 1/4 inch ball nose or radius at the tip of it. It looks like we're just about there. So what I'll do now is color this with a magic marker for a guide. And come back over it with the file with some real light strokes. To lessen the depth of the file marks on it. And the reason I colored it with a magic marker, if there's any low spots left on it, the low spots will show up as black when I get done filing it. So in other words, I'm trying to get all of the black removed, make sure there's no low spots in it, and a nice even profile, no sudden changes or no dips in it. That's looking pretty good. Stop that so you can see it better. There's just a little bit of the marker left down in the grooves that the file makes. But we'll switch to sandpaper now and smooth that out a little bit better. They're not really any dips in it. It's got the tops of all those grooves smoothed off. Now we're just finished taking those grooves out with some sandpaper. change out my alcohol bottle here to keep my sandpaper clean. Once the sandpaper loads up with metal, it won't cut anything. And it won't leave a nice smooth surface either. I use isopropyl alcohol for a lot of stuff. Go through bunches of it. You can see the bottle there, maybe. Just regular old rubbing alcohol. Squirt on the sandpaper, a little squirt on the metal. Trying not to get in the way of the camera. Hopefully I'm not covering it up too bad. Working on that transition area there. A little bit hard to do without covering up the view of the camera, because I usually do all of my work from the back side, but it's trying not to cover that up too bad. That was 80 grit sandpaper, and now I'm going to change to 120 and do the same thing. Okay, checking my radius on the end of it again, and I don't know how well that shows up on the camera. But I've got my radius right at a quarter of an inch. Like I said, now I'm going to change to the 120 grit paper and sand it out a little bit more. grip from the 120. And I'll hit it with some 320. I come out of the 220 out here in the shop. We'll go over with some 320 now. That's got her hit with 320. Got a pretty good finish on it. Not going to try to do anything else with this back here because I don't want to change the diameter. And these are spoon bits which work as a scraper, not a cutter. So actually the burr on the edges of it once it's milled is what will be doing the cutting and not a fine edge on the cutter itself. But for the tip down here, I wanted it to be nice and smooth and radiused, and make sure there was no dips in it. And my apologies for those that haven't been following me on Facebook. I didn't mention what this video was about at the beginning. But what I'm making here is what's called a spoon bit for pipe making. And the next step in the process will be to mill this down, or to mill half of it off. In other words, I'll just take and mill the top half of that off and be left from this scribed line right here down. I'll be left with a flat surface, half the profile, for half the thickness, half the diameter, half the thickness of the bit. All right, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and I'll try to do some more later. Thanks.